What's up, YouTube? Leo Sheng here, host of the Extreme Philly Fishing Channel. Today is May 11th, 2016. I'm here at a local creek in Northeast Philadelphia. This one here is called the Poquessing Creek. And this creek right here that flows this way is called the Byberry Creek. And our goal for today will be to wade and microfish both the Poquessing and the Byberry Creek. I will try to catch today as many different micro species as possible. Now, let me remind everyone that microfishing, right, is the same thing as the concept pretty much of fishing for species of fish that are less or equal than 6 inches. So if you're not into microfishing, this is not the best video for you, okay? You will have to wait for my future videos where I'm not microfishing. But anyways, you guys may ask me, Leo, what are you doing here? Why are you microfishing, right? Of course, I enjoy microfishing a lot, but that is not the only reason I'm here today. You guys have been bugging me a lot, you know, to start a new fish tank. And I finally got a new fish tank started. I'm running the nitrogen cycle, and that fish tank right now is going to be running for about 3 weeks. And after that, I am going to catch a few micro species from my local creeks and put inside my fish tank. So today, the goal is not only to catch smaller fishes here from the creek, but I also want to check which fishes, you know, are suitable for the fish tank. In other words, you know, what species are around here and what should I put inside the tank. As a matter of fact, at the end of this video, I am going to leave a poll for you to participate, you know, so you can voice your opinion and let me know which species of fish that I caught today the most. I mean, I haven't caught any yet, but you know, we will have a list of the species that I have caught today and which one you think is most suitable for a fish tank. So make sure to participate, okay? I'm starting here with my ultralight setup, 4 pounds test line with a Shimano Sedona 500 FD, Daiwa Spinmatic ultralight rod, right, at 5.6. And we're starting with a very small piece of nightcrawler on a size 12 hook. And mind, this is already pretty big for microfishing, so I'm pretty much going for the bigger species first. We're gonna catch the bigger species in this creek and then move on to the smaller ones, okay? So stay tuned, folks. As a matter of fact, I see our first victim of the day right here, right in front of me. So I'm just gonna swing the nightcrawler out there. What? That fish turned away on the nightcrawler? Oh no, he got it. Whoo! Our first fish of the day right here. I knew it. The creek is so clear that I can actually see this fish swimming around, you know? And this fella here was right in front of me, right? There we go. A beautiful and chubby red-breast sunfish, Dilipolmis auritus. That's our first species of the day. Let me take a few photos of this fella. Beautiful colors, and do a pretty unhook here for you guys. All right, let's quickly unhook our first sample for the day. Dilipolmis auritus, the red-breast sunfish. And since I will be wading the creek today, I have absolutely no fear of actually coming in the creek, you know, so I can give you guys some beautiful releases here. You see, this is a gorgeous fish right here, folks. Red breast sunfish. Full of energy, man. Quite aggressive too. Oh, I got one. What is this? It's species number 2 of the day. I saw this cool fish attacking my nightcrawler. Oh, it is a spot-tail shiner, our species number 2 of the day. A small spot-tail shiner on size 12 hook, all right? Spot-tail shiner, Notropis hudsonius, second species of the day, all right? Signature trait of this fish is the lateral line that is black and goes all the way back to the tail, and there's a little spot at the tail. That's why it's called the spot-tail shiner. Beautiful fish. All right, let me unhook here. In the range of 3 to 4 inches, perfect bait for catfish, okay? But anyways, let me take a few photos and release this guy. Oh, fish on. What we got here? Dude, there's gotta be a different one, right? Oh yeah, third species of the day, and look what a beauty, my God. It is a spawning common shiner. the Luxillus cornutus. Oh my goodness, we gotta take care of this one real quick because I want this one to spawn nicely, you know. Let's take a quick photo and release it. Let's quickly and gently unhook this fella here, this common shiner, because this is a spawning female and I definitely don't want to see this fish die in my hands. All right, this is a spawning female. Come on, come on. Ooh, oh yeah, look how fat that fish was, man. Fish is swimming right there. That's a fat fish. That fish is gonna give birth to a lot more common shiner in this creek. And truth be told folks, there are not a lot of common shiners in this creek, you know. So it is fundamental for even micro anglers to release fishes like that, release it nicely, you know. Whew. Piece of nightcrawler working well. There was the third species of the day, the Luxillus cornutus. Let's continue fishing, see how many more species we can catch. Oh, fish on. What we got here? Oh my god, look how beautiful this is. Goodness gracious. This is a spawning. Oh my goodness, this is a spawning common shiner. Look how beautiful this fish is. Look how beautiful this fish is. Dude, that's why I say, you know, the beauties of micro fishing. This is one of the most beautiful fishes that I've ever seen in my life, okay? As a matter of fact, I have announced in previous live streams, the common shiner is one of my favorite species of fish ever because it's just so colorful. Look how beautiful this is. Oh my goodness, let's take a full photos and release it. Final view of our common shiner here. Beautiful fish, all right? The Luxillus cornutus. You see all the red on its fins, signature of this fish, okay? That is such a gorgeous fish. Come on. Come on. Gotta make sure to swim away nicely. There he goes, look at that. Oh my God, look how beautiful that fish is in the water. Oh, that's why I say, folks, every time I see something like that, you know, people can make fun of me. They can tell me, you know, oh man, this is all bait fish, you know, you're fishing for bait fish, whatever, man. But when I see something like that, when I see something with colors that vivid, you know, it burns my soul, man. Because those who don't do micro fishing, they will never be able to appreciate that species of fish. They will never be able to appreciate, you know, such beautiful colors on a fish. That was gorgeous. Wow. All right, let's keep fishing. Oh my goodness. Another common shiner in spawning colors. And this one is even more into it. Check this out. This is such a beautiful, man. That's why I don't know how anyone can hate this fish, the Luxillus cornutus. I would never get tired of looking at a common shiner, you know, that has a spawning collar, seriously. You know, it's just too much beauty, you know? All right, go back where you belong, common shiner. Wow, check that out, huh? Whoo, that's beautiful. Fish on, big one. Oh man, of course it's a big one. It's a big ass red-breast sunfish. You know, come on. I want the big shiners. I don't want, but this is a beauty though. Whoa! Well, all right, it was a big red-breast sunfish, you know? What the heck, man? Well, all right, that was a nice sample though. I could fish for this every day, whole day, every day, man. There we go, we got another spot-tail shiner. A little bit bigger this time, but another beautiful sample and a spot-tail shiner. Notropis hudsonius, one of the most well-known species here from this creek. Yeah. Pow, there he goes. Beautiful day down here in the little creek, I gotta tell you that much. Although we have caught most of the bigger species, I'll probably be shifting attention to the smaller species now. I see a lot of the smaller sized fish over here, so I'm gonna downgrade my hook and see what we can catch. All right, folks, I caught the majority of the bigger species here, I believe. I mean, later we're gonna target the bigger ones again, but for now we're going to go for the smaller species. And I just wanted to show you guys, I just tied this on. I don't know how well you guys can see it or not in camera, but look, this is a size 26 hook, all right? Look, this is my middle finger. Look in comparison how small it is. This is a size 26 hook, and what I'm going to do, I'm going to put just a small piece of nightcrawler, and we are going to catch the smaller species here that are in the range of 1 inch to 3 inches. We're gonna do some authentic micro fishing now. Stay tuned, let's see what we can catch. Gotta make sure it sinks, otherwise the fish won't get it. Oh, it's sinking, it's sinking. Come on, come on. Yummy, yummy food right here for the smaller types of fish. I got it. There we go. This is what we call micro fishing right here. You see that? You see that? No, this is micro fishing, all right? This is authentic micro fishing. This is like a 1-inch fish right here. Okay, and let's see what we got here. This is a new species for today, that's for sure. And we got here a mummy chog. Yeah, this is a mummy chog. Authentic mummy chog. Don't know how well you guys can see it because I'm sorry, GoPro doesn't focus too well. But this is an authentic mummy chog. The fundulus, fundulus. This one is the fundulus heteroclitus. There you go. I gotta take a photo of this little guy so you guys can have a nice view of it and release it. All right, let me unhook the size 26 hook very carefully here because, you know, small fishes, right? They're very sensitive. They have very sensitive mouths. But there you go, right? We got here our size 26, whoa, we got here our size 26 cod, 1-inch fish here. Microfishing is best, a mummy chog. Now let me see, let me release it over here for you guys. Ah, see how small this is? This is very small. See that, you see that? And he's gone between my legs, but he's gone. Let's try to catch some more species. That was species number 4 of the day, and I'm confident I can catch some more different species over here, you know? But this is really the joy of micro fishing. Oh yeah, let's do it. Oh yeah. We got a highly parasitic banded killifish right here with a messed up tail too. Holy cow, look how many parasites this fish got. These black dots on this fish, they're all parasites, folks. And this is a banded killifish, the Fundulus diaphanus. A little bit different than the mummy chog, you know, both in the same genus, but this one got beautiful, beautiful vertical shiny bars, coloration wise. But yeah, this fish is like full of parasites, all right? Let me take a photo and release it. This species is number 5 for the day. Wow, I gotta tell you, I have caught plenty of banded killifish in the past. But you know, one that is actually this parasitic, meaning, you know, there are this many parasites on this fish. This is a new one even for me. Let me release it over here for you guys. Very beautiful 1-inch sample fish. You see how the banded killifish shines inside the water? This is how they are. They shine this beautifully, okay? So very, very beautiful fish. You see, kind of a fluorescent color. Yeah, there he goes, there he goes. See how beautiful this fish is? Gorgeous. You know what, I don't know if you ever noticed or not. Oh, it's gone. But I don't know if you ever noticed or not, but mummy chogs and banded killifish, they are actually surface-oriented fish. So when you look at their mouths, you know, their mouths is actually top oriented, you know, it's actually very fun. Very interesting species. All right, that was species number 5 for the day. Let's see what else we can catch. Let's see what we got here. Is is another mummy chog. Perfect mummy chog for a small, you know, perfect bait actually, you know, for smaller species of fish. We got here a mummy chog from the Byberry Creek, you know, beautiful. Pow, bye bye, 1-inch range. What we got here? Whoa, this may be a new species for me. Don't go anywhere, fish. This may be species number 6 for me here. There we go, we got a spot fin shiner. There we go, man, spot fin shiner. Species number 6 of the day. All micro species, all right. This one also in the range of 2 to 3 inches, but this is a legit spot fin shiner. Different than the spot tail shiner, it doesn't really have the black lateral line with the spot at the tail. This fish actually has scales that are going to a kind of a grill shape, I would say that way, you know? Beautiful sample, species number 6. There we go, what we got here? What we got here? Oh no, I snagged, but I snagged a mummy chog. Okay, that this doesn't count, but this is a beautiful mummy chog right here, all right? But this is a snag, so we're not gonna count this one, okay? Mummy chogs have different colors depending on if they're male or female, okay? I'm not sure if this is a male or female, but I can easily Google it and, you know, just let you guys know, okay? Beautiful colors, though. Beautiful mummy chog. Bye-bye. There we go. What we got here? Man, I snagged another spot fin shiner. No, what is this now? Is this a game of catching fish or snagging fish? I think snagged here a spot fin shiner. Beautiful sample though, but snag doesn't count, right? There we go, spot fin shiner for you guys to see here. Beautiful one too, all right? Beautiful, beautiful fish. Bye bye. What we got here? What we got here? We got another species for today, species number 7, the fall fish. There we go. Wow, a beautiful fall fish too. The Semotilus atromaculatus. Beautiful fall fish. Check that out. Species number 7 for today. It has this olive color to it, you know? Truly gorgeous. This is definitely one species that is a lot of fun to have inside a fish tank if you think about it. Okay, let's unhook this little fella here and do a very quick release right over here. Fall fish are sturdy fish. They're nice fish. They'll be fine. Come on, you'll be fine. I know that. Yeah, there we go. Swimming away nicely. He's good to go. Alrighty, species number 7. Whoa, there we go. That was a nice pool. It's gonna be a fall fish, right? Yep. When you have a nice pool like that, you know it's a fall fish. Because fall fish in this little creek, they're probably the fish that are hard to fight the hardest, you know? There you go. Gorgeous sample right here. About 3 to 4 inches. Beautiful fish. Hit on a night crawler as soon as it hit the water, you know? Just like they're supposed to do. And the thing is, this fall fish, they get big, you know? They really, really get big. So, you know, it's very fun. They don't get big in this creek, but they do get big in other places, you know? So lots of fun. There we go. What we got here? Oh, that's a nice one. Nice red-breast sunfish. Beautiful colors, at least. Just feeding here, you know, our local creek. Not bad at all. Here, go back to feeding, all right? Go back where you belong, fish. Whoa, species number 8 of the day. Check this out, a golden shiner. Notemigonus chrysoleucas, man. A golden shiner here at Byberry Creek. This is amazing. There we go. Legit golden shiner. I don't know where did this golden shiner come from, but this is a legit golden shiner. Species number 8 of the day. Wow, this is amazing. This is the first ever golden shiner that I have caught here at Byberry Creek, the Notebigonus chrysoleucas. This is a beautiful, beautiful specimen right here. Beautiful specimen. When you're ready.
is ready to go.
Wow, this is a beauty. This is a beauty, man. 8 species so far. Let's see how far we can go. All right, folks, we're pretty much end of the day. Catching 8 different species of fish here from the Byberry Poquessing Creek. You know, I thought it was pretty cool, do some micro fishing, you know, see all the different species of fish here in the creek. You know, and don't forget to participate in the poll, all right? And let me know which species should I take home later to, you know, add it to my fish tank, you know? Thank you very much for joining me today on this adventure. Now I have to wade about 2 miles upstream the creek. You know, it's gonna be a... I'm pretty tired, if you didn't realize yet by my sound of it, you know? But anyways, thanks for joining today's adventure. I'll see you next time. Tie lines and fish on. What the heck? What is this? You gotta be kidding me, man. What the fuck? What the hell, man?